Peggy 7.
In Rayman Legends, we really wanted to create new experience with the touch capability of the Wii U. So we use the gamepad in different ways. So you can really drag something, you can point on specific enemies in order to destroy them. Showing the path, the gyroscope allows us to completely manipulate the whole level. So you really have to talk. Asymmetrical gameplay is really the first thing you could expect from a Wii U game, just because you've got the different way of approaching the way of playing. On one side you've got the classic controller, on the other side you've got the gamepad, and it's really the key of the experience we wanted to build. In order to really experience the asymmetrical gameplay, we build a level that takes place in the Olympus world, where the gamepad player is moving a shield, a flying shield. And the very interesting thing is that the shield has two main tasks. First task, it can be used as a platform, and the other one is that it can protect the player. And we did that because we wanted the two players to interact depending on the situation. I've got to protect you, or you've got to jump on me, and then I can carry you somewhere. It's really doing things all together at the same time, but with completely different responsibilities. The musical maps is really something fun we wanted to do for a long time. When you play a platformer game, the music is very important. You want to play and you want the music to be really a part of the experience. This time we try to go further and to really have the feeling of mixing your actions and at the same time having the music completely synchronized. It's good.